Hello. Is it winter where you are? Are you dreaming of snowflakes,
falling,
cold weather, winter sweaters and cozy scarves?
Oh, hot cocoa and sitting by a fire?
If you are, you're in the right place. We have none of those things, but we have art that embraces one of those, two of those things.
Yeah. Oh, many of those
things. All the things. So we're going to show you a really cute, yes, adorable painting that you can do at home that we do with our students. And
we took inspiration from a Pinterest post,
yeah,
I don't know, years ago. And we kind of have just put our own spin on it, as we do. And
yeah,
we wanted to share it with you.
We don't know where it comes from.
So
partially our brain, partially the internet.
This is great for little kiddos all the way up to big kiddos. Doesn't matter. You can have fun with this.
Yeah, anybody can do
Anyone
it.
Anyone can catch
just
snowflakes.
Just like anybody, yeah, can catch snowflakes. So
please,
let's show you.
What do we need?
Oh,
Ash?
Right. Supplies. Okay. Well, as per usual, you can make it work in many ways. You are going to need some paint. Blue for the sky and liquid white for the snowflakes. However, we will give you other options as we're doing the art if you're like,
we love options.
I don't have that.
You don't want a blue sky? Any color will do.
Yeah, you're right. Or if you have puck paints.
So good.
Any kind of paint. Just get your hands on some paint.
But if you know Michaels, like we know Michaels, and if you're out there, Michaels, these are artist laws. Yeah. And this brand is amazing. They're only $7 Canadian, so that's like $2 American.
Yeah, and good luck finding anything that's less than that at Michael's. Always go with a coupon. Okay, you will need Q-tips.
Yes.
Q-tips, you will need Q-tips. And you will need
oil pastel?
Oil pastel.
Or a really thick marker.
Yeah, or like a thick crayon or something. Okay? Yeah. That's, I think that, paper.
Oh, of course.
Yeah. And a creative brain.
Some creativity.
That's it.
That's the easiest part, though. The creativity. Everything else is hard.
Welcome to our blank page, but let's not leave it blank.
Not for long.
Let's make winter fun.
Okay.
Sweet. You're going to start with a little mountain shape. This will be the nose. It could be big or little.
Okay.
But you want to leave a little bit of space,
mm-hmm,
and you're just going to make a little soft,
okay,
mine's like a hill, really.
Yeah. I'm going to make mine pointy, just
for
fun.
Oh, I like it.
Ah.
So cute. Now, the next step. We are going to connect these sides, but we're going to connect them with a big, giant, scoopy circle. Oh, yeah. Go large. Who cares? Your circle doesn't have to be straight. Oh!
So
fun.
This is like the nose and this is your face.
That's right. So you could add some nostrils.
Aww.
Okay. How cute. Or it looks like a big fat ghost at this point, but it's not going to stay that way.
Love it.
Okay. We need another scoopy lines because if there's one thing we love, it's scoopy lines.
Oh, we love a scoopy line.
So you're going to make one smiley scoopy line at the top of the shape you just created. Okay, so now you're going to connect those two lines with another giant, epic, scoopy shape. Oh, it's your mouth.
Sweet.
Oh, man, they're fun already. Okay, now you're going to add a tongue. You could one scoop it.
At the back.
Yeah, or what's better than one scoop, Amy?
Two scoops.
Yeah, double scoop. So I'm going to scoop like this. And do another one. There's a tongue chilling out in that mouth.
Nice. Ooh, I got a big one.
Because it's ready for all the snow.
Yeah.
What else is in your mouth? Some teeth.
Teeth.
Some teeth. Now, here's what's fun. You could do, we got options for days. You could do a ton of different types of teeth.
You can.
You could have teeth just coming across like this. You could do a straight line. You could have a missing tooth because this kid's playing hockey.
A chip tooth.
Okay. Or you could just come out with little, whatever. However you want to do your teeth. I'm going to show you can just make like a secondary scoop line.
I love it.
And then you could space these out. You could put braces
nice.
On
oh,
it.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to do individual teeth, I think.
Okay. I'm going to put a space in the center because I like that.
I'm just doing like chiclets, like, you know. Here we go.
Just making this a wider space. Teeth are so unique. Okay. This inside will end up being black, so if you put a space in your teeth like I did, it'll show up better later.
Yeah.
What do you need when you're outside and it's freezing?
Ooh, a cozy scarf.
That's right. You need a scarf. So you're going to make a big fluffy scarf. So we want to use rounded shapes. I'm going to make a rounded shape coming out here and a rounded shape coming out here. I'm sorry. I'm left-handed. You're right-handed.
That's right.
And here we are.
I'm not going to have a lot of room for my sweater, but that's okay.
Me neither. Then you connect.
Ooh.
Make sure you're connecting scoopy-ish.
Scoopy-ish. Make that sweater look 3D.
If you go straight, it's going to look crazy.
Funny. Yeah.
But, I mean, I guess that's okay. All right, and then you can make a tail on your scarf.
Ooh, okay.
I like to just do a squiggly line.
Mm-hmm.
And then another squiggly line that follows that same pattern. And then you can connect them with a straight line. Hey, fringe it up. Going right off the page. Why not?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You can add stripes to yours.
Okay.
What
all
do you
right,
want
right.
to do? You could have a solid scarf.
Yeah.
Hey, if you're drawing out there, you don't have to use a marker. I guess you could go with a pencil first if you're scared.
I'm going to do these kind of strange marks. I'm doing it.
Oh, I really love them. I love them. They ain't strange. They're perfect. Wow.
Oh, where is it going to take me? Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh.
Okay. Whoa, perfection. Okay, now you're going to make your body. And what's nice, if you don't have a lot of space, you're just going to make two kind of rounded lines right off the page.
Now, you don't want your shoulders to be coming inside your scarf. You want them nice and wide. Your shoulders are broad, so don't
Maybe.
Put them in. Well, don't put them inside your face. Put them a little bit outside your face.
It's true. Cool. If you had more space, you might be able to get arm lines in there.
Yeah. Oh, that's a good one.
Like you can see all these unfinished pieces. Okay.
Yeah.
You could do a little bit. Maybe I don't have as much space. I'll do two little ones. And now's the time to decorate.
This sweater.
Don't worry about the hair, guys. It's coming. To do larger shapes if you're going to be using a bigger paintbrush, and we're going to be outlining these in oil pastel, and that's got a thicker blunt edge, so you don't want anything too teeny tiny.
Mm-hmm. Let's do some hair on this.
Hair is so fun.
Oh yeah.
I'll do short hair maybe, or long. What do you want to do? You choose and I'll do the opposite.
I'll do some short hair.
Okay.
I'm just going to do like a really simple.
Oh, I love that.
Short hair. Maybe on this side and some on this side.
Oh,
as
I like
well.
That. Yeah. And when you're doing short hair, you can think about how your hair is. You could just have tiny little lines here and then you could fill it in. This guy's got a little bit waffier hair. I'm going to do longer hair. If you got long hair, you could just come down and bring hers down. I thought I was drawing a boy before.
Now
I've turned it into. Changed
These
my
are
tune.
Fun.
Changed my tune here. Yes,
Very
so
cool.
fun. You know, you could even do ponytail, you could do pigtails.
That's right.
Space buns, whatever you want. Okay. Painting time.
Hey, if you wanted to, you could add a few little, if you've got...
Les taches de rousseur.
Oui, freckles. You could add a few little freckles.
Oh, so cute. Yes.
Fun times. Okay, anyway.
Let's paint away.
We're going to start with the background here.
We're going to give you two options.
Yeah.
You could use liquid if you want a more solid, like we've done with these guys, or you could go with a washi type watery one that Amy's gonna do.
I'm gonna maybe do like a more of a dark evening sky.
Oh yeah, I might even add some white to this because I want it to be a little bit of a lighter blue.
So I'm making a dark night sky. He's out at night.
Do his parents know where he is?
Yes, of course.
Just out on the front lawn. Catching them snowflakes. Is the mouth. So you're going to fill in the whole mouth black. If you didn't have paint, and you want to fill this in, you could fill in your whole mouth with the marker or with the oil pastel too.
That's right. Now, you don't need paint for this project. Who needs paint?
Any project is adaptable. Mm-hmm. Look at that cool sky. And too, if you're drawing yourself catching snowflakes, you can imagine something different for yourself too. If you're like, I have brown hair, but I've always wanted pink hair. Well, why not add some pink to your hair?
Ooh, fun.
Why not?
Now, a great thing that we love to do with our kiddos is to figure out your skin tone or any skin tone that you want to have for your painting. So I want to do maybe a little bit of a darker skin tone. You may need to mix a couple colors together. I mean, it takes lots of colors to make a skin tone. So Don't get stressed, but just try and find one that works for you.
And everybody has to mix. We all have different skin
tones. That's right.
So I'm going to mix too. I guess I'll do something like next up.
Yeah.
We got to paint those tongues. Finish up the mouth.
That's right. Let's do it. Personality for days.
Hair. Well, really, you're just filling in the rest. You could do your sweater first. You do whatever. Mm-hmm. I'm going to do my hair first.
Found that some of your dark lines have kind of disappeared into the background. Now would be a good time to, once your painting is dry, I should say, mm-hmm. you can go over some of your lines with an oil pastel or back over it with your marker. And just bring some of those lines back in. So my hair kind of was covering up these details.
It looks so nice and dark. Mine's still pretty wet.
I'm just using an oil pastel to go over my lines. I love them so much. Hey. And that outline really just...
The outline is... It's not optional.
Yeah.
It's not. It's the best part. Okay.
Cute. So the final and most fun step of all.
Mm-hmm.
Let's do this.
Okay.
Some sweet little
snow. So you could use a little plate and get some white liquid paint. If you didn't have white liquid paint, you guys, you could use whiteout. Whiteout pen even.
And if you don't have a Q-tip, you can use the backside of your paintbrush, which works really well as well.
And dot up that snow. Oh, like they're catching it. Don't forget to get some in the mouth, too. She's getting big, guys.
Oh, yeah. Fun. And don't worry about them being all the same size. You know, snowflakes come in all different shapes and sizes.
Just like people.
That's right.
Oh! J'adore!
Moi aussi. Beautiful.
Cute. Look how sweet.
Fun.
Catch this creativity along with the snowflakes.
No kidding.
Yeah. Well, you did it. Hopefully you did it. And hopefully you love it as much as we do. They're adorable. We can't wait to see them.
As always, send us your pics. Come on, tag us.
And go enjoy that winter fun.
If you don't follow us on Instagram, it's at The Workshop Yay. So you can check us out. And anyway.
Thanks for catching snowflakes with us.
See you soon.
Catch them. Oh, no. Let us know.